Hello everyone, my name is Carolina Miozzi and I'm a biomedical engineering working with Radiosense, a spin-off of the University of Rome Tor Vergata. Today I will present you my work concerning a zero-power flexible RFID sensor for pressure monitoring of elastic compression bandages. Compression therapy through multi-layered bandaging is a complex medication used for the treatment of venous and lymphatic diseases of lower limbs. The application of the bandage with the correct tensioning and pressure of each layering is very difficult and strongly dependent on the personal experience of the nurse. The wrong application of this therapy not only compromises the success of the therapy itself, but can even provoke severe injuries to patients, such as pressure ulcers and similar. However, the interface's pressure is usually assessed on a subjective basis at the time of application. The need of a non-invasive pressure monitoring system to quantitatively assess the pressure between different layers of the medical dressings could help the greater diffusion and effectiveness of this kind of therapy. The proposal of this work is to design a pneumatic-based transducer made by an inflated biocompatible bladder to measure the pressure exerted by the bandage. Differently to other commercially available devices, our idea is to avoid the use of wires that inevitably complicate the system with the risk of damage and lack of comfort for the patient. So, the idea is to implement a wireless passive technology of communication in order to obtain a battery-less sensor device to be embedded within the bandage. Also in a multi-sensor configuration, readable by a handheld reader device through the bandage, and to minimize the electronic components in order to reduce the size and the complexity of the sensor, as well as its cost. So, the goal of this work is to develop a battery-less small-size sensor suitable for wireless pressure monitoring of elastic compression bandages, by using the radio frequency identification technology, so obtaining also a remote reading through multi-layer bandages. The work includes the design of a miniaturized pressure sensor, the prototyping of the device, and the preliminary electromagnetic and pressure measurements for its characterization. This is an exploded view of the RFID flexible board that consists of a core module, RF module, including all the electronic off-the-shelf components and a miniaturized antenna for energy harvesting and wireless data communication. The antenna is deposited over a Kapton substrate, and the whole device is sandwiched between two layers of latex foam and enclosed within a circular biocompatible polyurethane bladder, following the idea that I explained previously. Why the latex foam? Because thanks to the highly porous nature of the latex material, the air is naturally entrapped into the bladder without the need of active inflating, so greatly simplifying the manufacturing process. Namely, the trapped air is the medium that converts the external mechanical compression into a pressure that can be measured by the pressure sensor. More in detail, the core module is composed by a double-layer substrate that hosts all the RF and sensing electronics. In particular, the RFID IC with an RF front-end and an SPI bridge for interfacing with the microcontroller that interconnects the chip with the digital pressure sensor, which embeds also a temperature sensor, useful for further evaluations on the well-being of the patient. Concerning the antenna layout, it was optimized by using the electromagnetic solver tool CST Microwave Studio, including all the presented stratifications as well as an homogeneous phantom emulating the electromagnetic properties of the human limb, as reported in the table on the right of the slide. I would like to point out that the pressure sensor faces the human body, instead the radiating antenna is placed on the opposite side. So, this is the harvesting antenna layout, that is a mandated, miniaturized, dipole-like antenna. Here we have the three-dimensional radiation pattern at a fixed frequency in the UHF band that highlights the main direction of radiation, that is on broadside, as expected due to the presence of the human body, reach of losses. I want also to point out the bandwidth of the antenna that is large enough to allow a comfortable reading area for the user. We have also optimized the choice of the tuning inductors placed in series to the chip in order to maximize the power transmission coefficient, represented here, that gives an idea on how much power harvested by the antenna is effectively delivered to the electronics of the board. The power transmission coefficient must be optimized to the working frequency, namely the European UHF band, as obtained from this value of inductor. Finally, the distance we have obtained is suitable for wireless data reading through the bandages. The antenna was fabricated by cutting a flexible copper foil through a digital plotter, and it was then transferred over an adhesive substrate of Kapton. The antenna was then soldered to the RF pads of the core module, hosting all the SMD components. The latex substrates and the bladder were cut through hollow punches of the proper size, and the multi-layer device was then hermetically sealed. The resulting prototype, as you can see here from the photo, is flexible and soft, so comfortable for the application over the patient limbs, without risk of ulcers. First of all, I have performed an electromagnetic characterization by measuring the turn-on power, namely the minimum power that the reader should emit to activate the chip. We have used the measurement session tag formants Voyantic, that is a standard in the characterization of RFID antennas. We have performed the measurements over the arm of a volunteer, namely myself, and by changing the tuning inductors, we have tuned the device at the proper European frequencies in the UHF band. So, we have obtained a minimum activation power that is compatible with the portable interrogator emitting, for example, alpha path. Concerning the pressure measurements, first of all, the capability of detecting pressure variations applied by elastic bandages was demonstrated through a mock-up of a human limb made by a rigid epoxy resin cylinder, where I have applied the pressure by tightening a cable tie and by using a small forex plate to uniformly distribute the pressure over the target area, where is placed the sensor under test. We have obtained a linear trend with the sensitivity showed in the slide of the pressure with respect to the tightness of the cable. Then, I have performed a preliminary test of wireless acquisition of pressure data by progressively increasing the number of layers of a bandage-like tape, demonstrating that the sensor reveals an increasing pressure by increasing the number of bandages, as expected. The same test is repeated also over the limb of a volunteer, again by detecting the data of the sensor wirelessly through an handheld reader unit. So we have here demonstrated the usability of the system also on body. In conclusion, a backscattering-based soft and wireless sensor for the measurement of the local pressure inside the compression bandage has been presented. The hermetic encapsulation with a porous foam permits to use the air as transducer, avoiding the contact between the sensor and the skin. The device provides a linear response versus the bandage tightening. And the data can be collected by an external device and without battery source on board. So the sensor can stay for many days in the bandage and can also be reused after sterilization. Thanks to its low profile, multiple sensors can be used, even if further analysis and sensing tests should be performed on these in the next future. Moreover, a large campaign of measurements, including a clinical trial, will be performed in order to give usable information to the nurses. And finally, a user-friendly, customized software will be also developed for interfacing the reading system with a mobile phone.